Hi folks, Mick here. Hope you're all doing well. It's a Sunday afternoon, and I'm just out for a walk down my usual woods where I like to go camping. I'm not camping tonight, so I've just got my small bag with us. I'm actually going to do some cooking, I think. And I'm going to set myself a little challenge. Now, it's nothing big, it's just a little challenge that I like to do, just so I know that my skills is up to scratch. This is called yarrow. And it's a healing plant, or a healing herb. In fact, I think the legendary, mythical Achilles, I think he either used it to heal his heel, like his Achilles heel, or he covered himself in it. He forgot to cover his heels. Some of the story like that, maybe you folks can, tell the story. Well, I know it's something to do with Achilles' heels, hence the name of the tendon in your part of your foot, the Achilles' heels. But it's a very good herb for healing. Makes you sweat as well. So, you know, if you've got cold, you've got the man flu, you want something to sweat it out of you, and this is a good herb to use. So, I'm going to keep this, I'm going to collect a bit more, and I'm going to use it here on. Here's one for you. See this? It's called the Rosebeer Willow Herb. Yes, it's edible. You need the leaves when they're young. They're pretty old now, so the leaves are a bit tough. But another thing you can do is you can dig the roots up. The root is like a long system. You get the big root and the shoots come up. And what you can do is, you can bake the roots, crush it down, and it makes a coffee substitute. Well, that's the Rosebeer Willow Herb. Well, I've been walking along and I went and found some youngish leaves of the Rosebeer Willow Herb. I'm going to pick them, and I'm going to use them as well. Do. just starting to go into the woods now. I noticed this plant here. Now this plant is called plantain. Use a salad, eat it raw. I'm not going to eat it here because this place is well used for dogs, so dogs will be weighing on it and everything, so I'll not be eating it. But this is an edible herb called plantain. Very distinguished by the veins, as you can see, and the big stalk. It's like a tail. You know, I love this time of the year because this time of the year, the fruits and the trees are becoming ripe. I mean, look here. Got the blackberries. Yeah, delicious. What else? Got the rose hips. See them there? Here? Right, not bloom, but ripe, I mean. Rosy tea, beautiful. Here, look at the hawthorns. Hawthorn berries. These. I can't explain the taste of hawthorn. Right. Sit on the five. I'm going to sit down. What I've got here is a rose hip. A rose hip. As I say, it's edible. But what you want to do is you want to get rid of the seeds. Because seeds have little hairs on them. They irritate your skin and can irritate the back of your throat and stuff. So I've got a little piece here. Apple. It's lovely, mate. Dish. That's rose hip, and then the seeds. That's what you want to get rid of. And you can make tea out of them, cook with them, make a syrup as well. And here we are. Welcome to Camp Sagittarian. Right, so that challenge I talked about, I was going to set myself. Well, the challenge is making a fire from scratch. You could use in a survival situation, I suppose. If you need to make a fire, and there's no, you know, fine sticks, no kindling to make a fire with, then all you have is this. It's all you have to make a fire. And a fire steel, of course. How would you get a fire out of this? Well, that's my challenge. I'm going to set myself the challenge of making a fire out of this. Warm now. Oh, by the way, hi, let me show you this. What do you think of that? Is that mint or what? I don't need therapy. I just need to go camping. Can't buy them in the shops. Right, folks. So, a challenge, making a fire out of this. Well, for starters, if you notice, it's a birch. So that'll help us get the fire away. So basically, all we'll be using is my mini machete. Knife, and fire steel. That's all we'll be using to get a fire going with this. Right, folks, there you go. 300 pieces. What we're going to do is, we're going to cut one in a fine kindling, one in the thicker sticks, one in the thick logs. That's how you process the wood to get a fire going. First of all, I want to take some of this bark. For that, I'm going to use my Gerber knife. So what we're going to do is, we're going to chop it down into manageable pieces. There you go. I'm going to carry on processing the wood like this. Right, as you can see, I've got a nice pile here. And what you're going to do is, I'm going to carry on processing it down so it's finer. Try and stick like that. Right, folks, as you can see, I've written categorically sized my wood down to different sizes. I've got kindling, then next stage, pencil thickness size ones, then thicker ones, and then big logs. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a few of these and make some feather sticks. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is a feather stick. So I'm going to make a few of these and get some shavings. And I'll get back to you. So, when you make a fire, you want it off the ground. So, if there's any damp on the ground, it's not going to put your fire out. So, just like that. Right, next thing we want to do is we need to get some shavings off this birch bark. So I'm going to start shaving it like this, backwards and forwards. It is damp. But hopefully the oils in it will help it combust. Right, let's try that, eh? Ooh. Hey. Okie dokie, I think we have it. Now this way of making a fire, it's also used when the wood is wet. If you've got a log, on the outside it's going to be wet, but once you get to the inner pieces like this, they're going to be dry. Once you know your fire is established, you start putting the big thick pieces on. Oh, it's giving off some heat, that. Right, the forks. You might remember the other one. The other earlier one that I collected. What we're doing is we're taking the heads off. Like so. Just the heads. And then we've got some bay leaves. Pull a few of these in. The yellow leaves, the rose beer willow herb. Haven't got really much of a taste. Right. I think that should be enough for us. Maybe a little bit more. Yeah. And then, generous amount of olive oil. And give it a little warm up. Fry on the fire. Pour it out slowly. Excuse me. And some mashed potato. Yarrow war means it tastes peppery. I think I should have put the yarrow in last though, because the yarrow did burn a little bit. Never mind. So now, I've got a fire once at the enchilada.